Will we all die of hunger if we don't use genome editing? No, of course we won't. But if we don't use this, there are things that we have to give up.
Climate change forces plant populations to adapt to changes in temperature and rainfall. For three decades, 2020 Novozymes Prize recipient Detlef Weigel has studied what causes plants to bloom and how the future climate will affect their survival.
The answers that we got were really quite surprising. So we know that it's gonna become even drier around the Mediterranean. You might think, these Mediterranean populations are the ones that are most at risk. But it turns out that most at risk are the populations in Central Europe, because these plants basically have no genetic toolkit to deal with extended drought.
About 5 years ago, a PhD student, Moy Exposito Alonso, came to the lab and set up an extremely ambitious experiment.
He took hundreds of strains that we had collected from all over the world, where we had the entire genomes, and then we simulated rainfall of Tübingen and Madrid. One of the most important discoveries there was that it's rare to find genes that are helpful in both conditions. In the Mediterranean, it's already not so rare that you have drought, and so they should be able to adapt relatively quickly, whereas in Central Europe, that is not really quite the case. Of course, our goal should be limit the amount of CO2 that we put in the air, but we also know that things are complicated, that things might take time, and we need to have a few other aces up our sleeve to deal with climate change.
The latest report of the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change specifically mentioned genome editing as a valuable tool to help plants to adapt faster.
If I put myself into the shoes of a consumer who is faced with the choice of, here's a tomato and here is another tomato, but this tomato has an extra gene. The conservative approach is, why should I take the tomato with that extra gene?
But the tomato that has not been genome edited to be more sustainable comes at a cost.
The more land we use for agriculture, the less land there is for trees to grow. And trees is still one of the best methods that we have to remove CO2 from the air. It's a method that we know really, really works. So it would be absolutely shameful if we did not use these modern tools for biotechnology.